Okay, exponential decay function, 7.2. So the function for exponential decay is a little bit different than the function for exponential growth. Exponential growth, our function was f of x equals b to the x, yeah? Here it's the same equation. Do you see that? F of x equals b to the x. The only difference is, what do you think our exponent is going to be? A negative. Okay. 0 would be less than b. B would be less than 1. Okay. When you are dealing with this, your domain, okay, is always all real numbers. Okay. Your range will depend on what's going on. How do you think we should solve or graph y equals 1/2 to the x? What do you think we should do? Do you see how this number right here? What number is this? What type of number is this?
That's a fraction.
Anytime you have decay, this is how you tell decay from growth.
Okay.
This number is a fraction, okay, or less than zero, less than 1. When you have growth, the number is always greater than 1, okay? So you'll have a whole number that's higher than 1 if it's growth, and decay is less than 1, between 0 and 1. So here's the deal. You should be able to look at any of these equations and tell me if they're growth or decay without doing work, okay? How do you think I'm going to go about solving this? What do you think I need to do?
Plug.
Yeah, let's just plug in some points again, like always, right? Let's plug in our standard easy stuff. Negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. Now, when I plug negative 2 up here, what does that do to this equation?
It flips it.
It flips it. So then I end up getting 2 squared over 1 squared, correct?
Yes.
What's 2 squared?
4.
And 1 squared is 1, so 2 divided by 1, or 4 divided by 1 is? Now, if I plug a negative 1 in here, what's going to happen to it again?
It's
going to
flip.
So 2 to the first over 1 to the first gives me?
2.
Anything to the 0 power is what?
1.
If I take a half to the first power, what do I get? Yeah, 1/2. Because it's 1 to the first and 2 to the first. If I square it, that means I have 1 squared over 2 squared, which gives me what?
1/4,
because I get 1 up top and I get 4 on the bottom. So I go ahead and graph these. Negative 2, positive 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Negative 1, positive 2, 0, 1, 1/2, and 2 here. This is exponential decay. Cool? What do we know when we come over to this blue graph looking at this? What do we know? What does that 2 tell me?
Same stretch.
Yep, beautiful. So, all I need to do is plug in numbers again, correct? Negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. Okay? When I plug in negative 2, my original equation says 2 times 1/4. And if I do it to the negative 2, what happens there? I get 2 times, what happens to my fraction?
It would be 4 over 1.
It would be 4 squared over 1 squared. What's 4 squared?
16.
And over 1 is?
16.
So 16. 16 times 2 is?
30.
32. So do you see how you can have some pretty big numbers with this pretty quickly? Okay. If I take it and I put a negative 1 here, what happens? They flip, right? So I get 4 to the first over 1 to the first. So 4 divided by 1 is 1. What is 2 times 4?
8.
Anything to my 0 power is
4.
But I have 1, and then I have times 2. So 1 times 2 is 2. If I plug this in and put it to the first, what's 1/4 to the first? 1/4, take 1/4 times it by 2, what do you get?
1/2.
1/2. When I reduce, good. And then I'm going to put a 2 up here. When I do that, that means I am squeezing. squaring both portions of this. So I have 2 times 1 squared over 4 squared. What's 4 squared again?
16.
16. So I have 1 16th times 2. What's 2 times 1 16th? 1/8. So we're going to go to negative 2. Ooh, let's count by, I only put 10 on here. So let's count by 4s. Just pretend with me. I'll go higher than it is. So let's say that that's way up here. Got it? And then negative 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. Let's go there. Okay? And then 0, 2. And then 1 and a half. And then 2 and 1 eighth. Exponential decay. Doesn't look quite as fun as our growth ones. I like the sound of growth better than decay.
Yeah, it's making
me
money.
Yeah, making me money. This ain't doing nothing but draining my bank. So we need the exponential growth. Okay, on this black graph, what do we know that's going to happen to this? There's 2 things. Okay, it's going to flip. And what's the other thing tell me? It's going to stretch by 3 units. Beautiful. Okay, let's plug in some numbers. I'm going to plug in them up here since I know it's flipping. I'm going to use this space wisely. Negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. So on your homework tonight, you're going to have lots of little charts for me. Okay? If I have negative 3, 2 fifths to the negative 2, what does that do to this? So I end up getting negative 3 times 5 squared over 2 squared. What's 5 squared? 25. What's 2 squared?
4.
I would just suggest go ahead and just divide that out and give me decimal answers. It might be easier for you than fractions. Okay, so 25 divided by 4, and then I have to multiply it by negative 3, right? Is that correct?
Yeah.
And then multiply it by negative 3, and I get negative 18.75, so negative 18 and 3/4. Okay, I'm fine with decimal answers. If I plug in a negative 1, right, what do I have to do now? Flip it again. What is 5 to the first is 5, 2 to the first is 2, so 5 seconds, times negative 3. What do you get? Negative 7.5. Okay. Always my favorite and easiest, anything to the zero power is.
1.
So 1 times negative 3 is? Beautiful. Now I have to the first power, which means I literally take 2 fifths and multiply it by negative 3. So if I take 2 fifths and multiply it by negative 3, you get negative 1.2. And if I have this squared, right, for the last one, that means I have negative 3, I have 2 squared, I have 5 squared. 2 squared is? 5 squared is. So 4 divided by 25 times negative 3 gives me negative 0.48. Beautiful. Now, we graph this. Negative 2, negative 18. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18.75, roughly about here. Negative 1, 7. And a half to 4, 6, 7 and a half-ish. And 0, negative 3, 2, 3. And 1, negative 1.2. And 2, negative almost half. Yes? Look. Exponential decay. It flipped like it was supposed to, right? And now we and it stretched by 3 units. Beautiful. Now, of course, on the purple one, we have to do a little bit more work, yes? Okay? We have state, domain, and range, and we have to shift things. Remember on the last one, I told you focus on this first, and then we'll come back and shift? We're going to do the same thing. Focus on that first, then we'll come back and shift.
Would it be the same? X plus 1, definitely shift that.
Yeah, like same types of shift as we did last time, yes. So if it's plus 1, it shifts it opposite on the x-axis, and on the y-axis, it shifts it true to what the sign is. Yes.
Okay.
That's what you're asking, Cole?
Yeah.
Okay. So x, y, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. And my equation right now that I'm focusing on is 3 times 1 half to the x, yeah? If I plug a negative 2 in there, right, it changes it to 3 times 2 squared over 1 squared. What's 3 times 4?
12.
12. You following, Drew? If I change this to a negative 1, right, it flips it to say 3 times 2 over 1. What's 3 times 2?
6.
If I change this to 0, what happens? Makes it 1. 1 times 3 is?
3.
Look at this. Do you see this pattern 12, 6, 3? What's happening there?
It's going down by 3.
It's going down by 3s. What are we multiplying by on the outside?
3.
3. Do you see a pattern going on? If I put a 1 in, what do you think it's going to do? 3 times a half, right? What's 3 times a half? 1.5.
Yeah.
That's dividing. Yep. And if I take this and square it, that means I get 3 times 2 squared over 1 squared, right? 2 squared is, not 2 squared, I flipped it for no reason, so I'm being silly. So 3 over, or 1 squared over 2 squared times 3, so 3 times 1 fourth, which would give me 0.75 or 3 fourths, yes? Now I graph this and then we're going to shift. Negative 2, positive 12, 1, 2. Then I have negative 1, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then I have 0, 3. And then I have 1, 1 and a half. And then I have 2 and 3 fourths. So this is the original graph, yes? Okay. It's decreasing, it's doing what it's supposed to. Now, let's come back and shift this sucker. How do I shift this? If it has a plus 1 with the y and a minus 2, how do I shift it?
The x is plus 1
and minus 1.
The x is plus
1. You go left 1.
Yes. Thank you, Drew. The x is opposite of its sign, so I'm subtracting 1 from all these points, which is left 1, which is what Drew said. And then what do I do with the negative 2? Subtract it, so you're going down 2. Left 1, down 2. So these new points, if I write them out without just doing this, okay, I would have negative 3, right, and then 10 as a point, okay? So if I go to negative 3, 10, that should be here. And if you see, it went over 1, down 2, yes? Okay. Then I should have negative 2, 4. So negative 2, 4 should be right there. Okay? Then I have negative 1, and I have 1.5 minus 2. What's 1.5 minus 2?
Did you skip?
Did I skip? I did skip. What's 3 minus 2?
1.
So I have negative 1, 1. Negative 1, 1. Now I do negative 1 and 1 together, which is 0. And what is 1.5 minus 2?
Negative
0.5. Negative 0.5. Good. Negative 0.5. So 0, negative 0.5, right? And then 2 minus 1 is 1. And what is 0.75 minus 2? Negative 1.25. Yep. So 1 and negative 1.25. And this is your actual graph of that function. Now, domain and range. What is your domain of this function?
All real numbers.
All real numbers. Now tell me, what's my range?
Y is greater than negative
2. Y is greater than negative 2. Because it comes from this.
I thought it wasn't supposed to cross the x. that for?
If, before we shift, it doesn't. If we have shifts on it, it will. Those rules leave, okay? Those are the things you are working on tonight, okay? It's the same concept as the last 2 days, it's just decaying instead of growing.